Hi guys, my name is Dr. Lori Zellinger and I'm a child psychologist. That means that more than anything, I want to help children understand their feelings and behavior and help adults understand children. Some people call me a feelings doctor. You might even know some other feelings doctors besides me. That means that I know about all kinds of feelings that kids have. Happy and ecstatic and sad and miserable and just uncomfortable, scared, worried. One of the feelings though that I want to talk about is confused. Sometimes kids feel confused because they hear something and they don't understand it. And sometimes they're confused because adults don't want to talk about some of the things that the kids are hearing because they don't want to upset children. I'm going to be talking now about something that has confused children. It's an idea called terrorism. I'm going to try to tell you parts of my story and parts of my book without making it too scary so that you can understand what terrorism is. So this video is for you, but adults, if you want to stick around and listen, please feel free. I want to read you parts of a book that I wrote for kids and for parents. It's called Please Explain Terrorism to Me, A Story for Children, Pearls of Wisdom for Adults, for their parents. So this is a story about a boy who comes home from school and sees the TV on, doesn't know what's going on. He can't really make sense of it, and his mom is in the kitchen with his little sister. "Mom, what's that mean? What's going on?" Coming from the living room TV, I heard the announcer say, "Breaking news, 7 injured, 6 known dead." Then lots of big words that I couldn't understand. I couldn't figure out. Emergency situation, death toll, high alert, terrorists, group taking responsibility. And his mom comes running out of the kitchen. She doesn't know what's going on yet either, but she tries to distract him and take him into the kitchen. There's something that she didn't want him to know. And the boy says, the look on her face told me this was serious. Something terrible had happened. When the dad came home and they all had dinner, everybody avoided talking about this. They talked about everything else, but the parents didn't want to discuss this with the child. At bedtime, he just wanted to cozy up with his stuffed animals and his action figures, and just to make everything act like the way it usually is. And I have pictures of the child in school and on the bus and with his friends and his big brother Noah playing video games with his friend. And then, by nighttime, the child is afraid to go to bed. And perhaps you can see some of these pages, but this is a page that looks like all of his nightmares. He sees monsters and extraterrestrials and animals with horns, and he's scared. When he goes to school the next day, he hears an announcement over the loudspeaker that there's going to be a lockdown. And I know that you know what a lockdown is because the schools are all practicing it. So here, his teacher tells them to get ready for the lockdown because in a few minutes there will be an announcement. After a few minutes, the principal comes on the loudspeaker and says, "Prepare for lockdown." And so, that was when Mr. Myers, their teacher, told us to stop what we were doing and take our places along the wall or in the back while he locked the classroom door. We hurried to a spot, sat down, folded our arms and tucked in our legs so that we could be as small as possible. And then we waited very, very quietly. I gotta tell you, it was a little boring. But after a while, the voice came back on and said, "The lockdown is over. Boys and girls, you did a wonderful job." I walked through the halls and tried to peek in the rooms and I couldn't see anybody. If this was a real emergency, you would be very safe. Congratulations. You should feel very proud of yourselves. Then, after school, his brother comes and says that they had an evacuation drill. And our main character is saying, well, what's going on with that? What's going on that mom and dad won't talk to me about? Finally, he got the courage to ask his parents about the things he was wondering about. And they told him, there are all kinds of people in the world, and some of them feel and act differently than we do. They break the law, and they want to make sure that their own, and they want to make their own rules because they think that they are right. Think of them as bullies who are very, very angry and full of hatred. When other people don't believe in the same idea as they do, they want to teach them a lesson. These bad guys hurt and kill people and mess up things in neighborhoods and try to make everyone scared. Some of them are even willing to die for what they believe in. They're only happy when people are terrified. That's why they're called terrorists. Even though you're only hearing about terrorism now, it's been around for a long time. My parents saw that I was scared and told me that even though these bad guys did a terrible thing, there were a gazillion helpers who were furious with the terrorists, and they were there to help. Doctors and nurses fixed the people who were hurt, and firefighters put out the explosions. Construction workers fixed things that were ruined, and policemen and women went hunting for the bad guys. Regular people helped too in ways that they could think of. And loads of other people were doing very important things that we couldn't even see. In fact, there's even a very important group called Department of Homeland Security that works day and night to keep America safe against terrorists. There are a lot more good guys than bad guys. And there are even some people that we don't even know about. They're undercover and they look just like, they're dressed just like we are, but they're protecting us too. Thinking about terrorists can be scary, but there are a lot of things, even metal detectors and airports, there are a lot of ways that we're staying safe. And you know that saying, if you see something, say something. There are a lot of other people helping to keep you safe. All around us, our friends and our neighbors are helping to watch out and to help us make good decisions. It's okay for kids to just go about being a kid. You can have fun and you can play and you can ride your bike and play baseball and soccer and hockey and take dance lessons and gymnastics and sing and do all the things you want to do. It's up to the grown-ups to take care of you, and they love you, so they're doing a real good job trying to keep you safe. So it's important to have fun and be a kid and leave the worrying to the grown-ups. They'll tell you what you need to do. And speaking of grown-ups, there's a part at the back of the book for grown-ups, for the adults in your family and in your school. And this section is for parents. I offer 6 pearls of wisdom, and that's an acronym. The P is for prepare, the E is for, excuse me, explain. The A is for answer. The R is for reassure. L is listen to your kids. And S is for safeguard. These pearls of wisdom can be applied to almost any difficult conversation that you need to have with children. Certainly not just about terrorism, but anything that you don't know how to begin or you don't know how to carry out. These pearls of wisdom are guidelines for grown-ups, so they should help you to navigate any kind of situation that you may have been trying to avoid or may have been dreading having with your kids. If you'd like a copy of the book or you'd like to know more, they're available. All of my books are available on Amazon or my website, which is drzellinger.com. That's drzellinger.com. And if you'd like to get in touch with me or learn about our practice, there's information about that there also. Thanks for listening.